Please look here and tell me what is the difference between Hamza in the next word is أختي الطائرة. I don't know, teacher. Okay, no problem. Please watch this video with teacher Shaima Bahr. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. How are you, my student? Welcome in Quran class. My name is Shaima Bahr. I am Quran and Arabic teacher. Inshallah, I will step by step with you to learn Quran, Tajweed, and Arabic lesson. In this video, we will learn together a new Tajweed lesson. The lesson today is about Hamzata al-Qat'i wal-Wasl. Let's start with types of Hamza. أشكال الهمزة. No, types means أنواع. أنواع الهمزة. Listen to the colored Hamza. Click on it to learn its type. Number one, الشمس والقمر بحسبان. Please look at the shape of the Hamza. It's a Hamza. وصل. لمن شاء منكم أن يستقيم. همزة قاطع. إذا الشمس كورت. إذا همزة قاطع الشمس همزة وصل. الرآب استغنى. همزة قاطع. Forms of Hamza. There are two forms of Hamza. همزة قاطع and همزة وصل. أين همزة وصل؟ همزة قاطع means small circle, small, not complete circle, without short tail. But همزة وصل, small head for letter صاد. Definition of همزة. همزة وصل means it leads to pronouncing the second letter. It's written, but it's not poison. The letter following it is always ساكن, like تعلمت الصلاة. Okay? Okay. But همزة وصل, همزة قاطع means it separates the pronouncing of a word. The letter following it can be ساكن or متحرك, like مأرب. مأرب. How to distinguish between Hamza Wasl and Hamza Qat'i? How that? Add vowel or fa before the word. If the Hamza is pronounced, then it's Hamza Qat'i. But if Hamza is not pronounced, then it's Hamza Wasl. Example, Asma. When you add vowel before the name, it will be Wa Asma, Wa Asma. Can you hear the sound of Hamza? Yes or no? Yes. So it's what? It's Hamza Qata. But واستكبارا, واستكبارا. Can you hear the sound of Hamza? No, it's Hamza Wasl. Yes, very good. Okay. وأخذا, Hamza Qata. But واستمع, it's Hamza Wasl. Okay. Positions of Hamza Qata and Hamza Wasl in nouns, verbs, and letters, حروف. مواضع همزة القطع والوصل في الأسماء والأفعال والحروف. Number one, in letters. The positions of همزة القطع and وصل in letters, الحروف. همزة وصل comes only in one letter, the lam in al. whether it was شمسية like الشمس or قمرية like القمر. That's the Hamza was. In nouns, all nouns with Hamza Qatar begin with Hamza Qatar, except for seven nouns, namely والذكور اسم الله عليه عيسى بن مريم إن امرؤ هلك ومريم ابنة عمران وإن امرأة خافت نساء فوق اثنتين ثاني اثنين. Okay. Hamza Qatra and Hamza Was in Berbers. The positions of Hamza Qatra and Was in Berbers. Number one. Let's start with the verb had three letters. الفعل الثلاثي like كتب. In present, it will be أكتبه. أكتبه. That means any verb has three letters, الفعل الثلاثي. In present, it starts with Hamza Qatar. Hamza Qatar, you can find it in present of فعل الثلاثي. Verb has three letters. Okay. Amr. Amr means order, like oktob. Oktob. Oktob starts with Hamza Fast. Amr al-Thulathi. That was. Fast in the past. Madi al-Thulathi. Akala. Akala. It's Hamza Qatar. Masdar. مصدر الثلاثي أكلا أكلا it's Hamza Qatar. Okay. Let's go to الفعل الرباعي. That means the verb has four letters. فعل رباعي. Any verb has four letters. فعل رباعي. Doesn't start with Hamza Qatar or Hamza Wasl. Okay. Amr, order, like Arsal. Arsal. Start with Hamza Qatar. Madi past, like Arsala. Arsala. It starts with Hamza Qatar. Masdar, like Irsal. Irsal. It's Hamza Qatar. Okay. Let's go to Fa'al Khumasi. Verb has five letters. Any verb has five letters. فعل خماسي. Does it start with Hamza Qatar or Hamza Wasl? In present, no. Or that like in طلب. It's Hamza Wasl. Madi past like in طلقة. In طلقة. It's Hamza Wasl. Masdar. Masdar خماسي like in طلاق. It's Hamza Wasl. Okay. Let's go to the verb sudasi. Al-fa'l sudasi. Verb has six letters. Any verb has six letters. Doesn't start with Hamza Qatar or Hamza Basra. Like, but in order, like, it steps this. It starts with Hamza Basra. Starts with Hamza Basra. Maadi like, istakbara. Istakbara. It's Hamza Qatar. Masdar like istikbaran. It's Hamza Qatar. Okay. How to begin with Hamza Qatar? How that? Okay. I'll tell you now. How? Number one, with Dhamma. Begin Hamza Qatar. The vowel is Dhamma. The sound is Dhamma. With Dhamma, if the third letter of the imperative verb has Dhamma. The third letter of the imperative verb has Dhamma, like unzur, usjud. Okay. But with Kesra, if the third letter of the imperative verb has Kesra, like اذهب اذهب اضرب. اوكي now let's know the cases of إثبات and حذف for همزة الوصل. حالات الإثبات والحذف من همزة الوصل. Number one. There are four cases. Always written. تكتب دائما. Can be omitted or written. يمكن أن تحذف أو تكتب. Written but not pronounced. تكتب ولا تنطق. Neither written nor pronounced. لا تكتب ولا تنطق. Let's start with always writing. تكتب دائما. Example. الذي الذي همزة الوصل not omitted لا تحذف. It's not lazy. No, lazy is wrong. Number two. Can be omitted or written. يمكن أن تحذف أو تحذف. Like الشمس. It's allowed to omit it. Hamzat was. It will be Shams. Number three. Writing but not pronounce it. تكتب ولا تنطق. Like. If the name preceded by حرف جر. Like من المسجد. It's writing but not pronounce it. عن المسجد. إلى المسجد. في المسجد. على المسجد. Okay. Number four. Neither writing nor pronouncing. Like للصلاة. للصلاة. It's omitted. In writing and in pronouncing. Okay. Please read the next examples. And take care the rules of Hamza Post and the pattern. Number one, can you read? Maryama Banata Imran. Can you read? Try, please try. Try to read the next example, okay? Try. Try and write in comment. Please try to read. Try. That's your homework. Okay. Now let's develop your listening skills. Let's develop. Okay. Please look at the board. What can you notice? Okay. When Hamza Fasl is followed by a mad letter, the first second the mad letter is on my day, according to Hafs. Okay. Like. Look at this word. The correct is اقضوا. No, no اقضوا. It's اقضوا. Why? Because the third letter has ضمة. That's the right. But the wrong is اقضوا. Okay. Please look at the example. Ibn is a noun that begins with Hamza Wasl. It's omitted during continuous recitation. Okay, like the right is, the correct is, please repeat after me. Isa ibn Maryam, the correct, but the wrong is. Isa ibn Maryam. That's wrong. Okay. Please look here. Isnain begins in Hamzat Wasl. It can't be changed into Hamzat Fatha. The correct is La tattakhidu ilahayn isnain. That's the right, but the wrong is La tattakhidu ilahayn isnain. That's wrong. It's not Hamza Fath, it's Hamza Fath. Okay. Now, I want to test your knowledge. Are you ready? Okay. I will ask you three questions. Number one, true or false. Number two, choose a correct answer. Number three, Listen and choose the correct pronunciation. Let's start with true or false. Please tell me, right or wrong. Hamzat last is admitted in the beginning of recitation and omitted during continuous recitation. True or false? True or false? Yes, it's a true. Okay. Hamzat Qata is admitted in the beginning of recitation and omitted during continuous recitation. True or false? Yes, it's wrong. Hamzat last is found in nouns and verbs only. True or false? Wrong. No, it's wrong. Hamzat last got its name because it leads to the pronunciation of the second letter at the beginning of the word. True or false? Yes, true. Hamzat last is only found in verbs in the past and imperative form. True or false? Yes, true. The word ibtala begins with Hamzat Qata. Right or wrong? No, wrong. Okay. Yes. The word ibtala begins with Hamzat Qata. No, wrong. Hamzat wasl is found in 10 nouns in the Arabic language. Ibn, ibna, imru, imra'a, ibnan, isnatan. Right or wrong? Yes, it's true. Now let's go to the third question. Choose the correct answer. In the it's the second, not the same. In the Arabic language, which one is right? Yes, the first one. We found to begin with second letter. No, stop at a mutaharrik letter. Number two, Hamzat last is found in nouns, letter, and verbs. Yes. Hamzat last in letters is found in, yes, the definition of take both Shamsiya and Qamariya. Hamzat last is neither written nor pronounced if added to the preposition letter. Now, yes. Which of the following words begin with Hamzat last? Yes, Emre. If we begin the recitation with Ahadun Allah, yes, Kasra will be added to Hamzat last. Good. Now let's go to the last part of our questions. It's listen and choose the correct pronunciation. Please listen. Number one. Number one. ادعو إلى سبيل ربك بالحكمة والموعظة الحسنة. Number two. ادعو إلى سبيل ربك بالحكمة والموعظة الحسنة. Which one is right? Udru, number one. Number two, Udru. Maryam ibnat Imran. Number one, it's. Wa Maryam ibnat. Number two, it's. Wa Maryam. Number one, wa Maryam ibnat. Number two, wa Maryam ibnat Imran. Which one? Wa Maryam ibnat. Number one is right. Okay. واذكر اسم الله عليه. Number one is واذكر اسم الله عليه. Number two واذكر اسم الله عليه. Which one is right? Which one? Yes, number one. Good. وإن امرأة خافت. Number one. وإن امرأة خافت. Number two. وإن امرأة خافت. Which one is right? Yes, number two. Good. Okay. Very good. You finished the test. Excellent. Very good. Congratulations. I am proud of you. Okay. Now it's time to leave you. That's great to see you today. Please, if this video is useful for you, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.